Hello everyone, today I'll discuss whether it's beneficial to warm up a diesel engine, specifically a 1.6 HDI engine, 120 horsepower. So, as you may have already guessed, it's necessary to warm up an engine before driving. There are countless videos, articles and more about this topic, it's pointless to debate this. But there is a lack of material specifying the specifics of up to what temperatures you should warm up the engine in a real car, how long it would take, as well what you are able to warm up and which components you can't. You'll see directly here we have a 1.6 blue HDI engine with 8 valves and 120 horsepower on a 2015 Peugeot 308T9. Lucky for you, it's a unique opportunity. Let's not delay. The outside temperature is 8 degrees Celsius. The engine is of course cold. Let's see what happens. The first thing that starts to warm up is the exhaust system. Literally 20 seconds and the temperature is already under 20 degrees in the area of the exhaust manifold. Then another 10 seconds passed and the serpentine belt had already heated up to 15 degrees. About 30 seconds have passed, the temperature in the area of the exhaust manifold is 32 degrees. The crankcase gas sensor also heats up to about 15 degrees. Everything else is quite cold. 1 minute and 20 seconds passed and the generator started to warm up to about 20 degrees. The belt temperature is 18 degrees. The exhaust manifold is still warming up. Temperature in the area of the spark plug injectors. Glow plugs are 16 degrees. The crankcase gas sensor is 32 degrees. The turbine has warmed up to 30 degrees. Let me remind you, 2 minutes have passed. It is clear that the power fuses are starting to heat up, but not critically at all, 11, 12 degrees. The radiator, as you can see, is still cold, which is logical in principle. 3 minutes have passed. The temperature in the area of the exhaust and turbine was 60, 65 degrees. The generator warmed up to 32 degrees. The area of the spark plug injectors. The plug injectors warmed up to 25 degrees. But let me remind you, 4 minutes have passed. Overall, the picture is something like this. The engine is slowly starting to warm up. 4.5 minutes. Coolant temperature is 19 degrees. Positive terminal temperature is 11 degrees. Power fuse box is at plus 14. Here's the overall view of the engine. 5 minutes have passed. Turbine area is 60 degrees. Cylinder head number 4. Expansion tank 9 didn't heat up. 6 minutes have passed. Alternator is 37 degrees. Belt is 28 degrees. Glow plugs and injectors roughly 30 degrees. 7 minutes have passed. The turbine and converter are about 70 degrees. Oil filter housing is 25 degrees. The gearbox housing gears are 14 degrees. The coolant is 27 degrees. The converter is 77 degrees. The cylinder head is 34 degrees. The spark plugs and injectors, 8 minutes have passed and it's still 34 degrees. The generator is 44 degrees. 9 minutes have passed. The converter is 84 degrees. The cooling radiator is predictably cold. Ten minutes have passed. The cylinder head cover is starting to warm up. The converter is 85 degrees. The antifreeze temperature is 32 degrees. A little more than 10 minutes have passed. So 10.5 minutes of warming up. And this is roughly the overall picture. The outside temperature is 8 degrees, by the way, and so that there's something to compare it to, here's what a fully heated engine looks like after about 200 kilometers on the highway without stopping. The highest temperatures are in the converter area, about 130 degrees. The body at the air intake is 27 degrees, and the outside temperature is still 8 degrees. Let's take a closer look. The converter is heating up to 152 degrees. Closer to the turbine, it's 80 to 90 degrees. The coolant temperature is 86 degrees. The expansion tank has finally warmed up to about 50 degrees. The head cover is about 70 degrees and the spark plug nozzles are around 88 degrees. The alternator is around 60 degrees. Suddenly the engine cushion is 66 degrees. If anything, it's just aluminum. The air filter housing is 23 on top, 40 to 45 on the bottom. The air supply pipe after the filter is 25 degrees, the turbocharger noise muffler, the rest of the air pipes are around 40 degrees. So they say something like this. I think you've seen everything yourself. Adding anything else would be really hard. What conclusions can we draw from this? Probably everyone will decide for themselves. But more visual information about the 1.6 engine on French cars seems to me is unlikely to find. That's all I got for today. Thank you all for watching. Safe travels to everyone. Bye for now.